In this lecture, we'll talk about the apparent motion of the sky. We're going to learn why the stars appear to rise and set, why the sky looks different from different locations on Earth, and how the sky varies over the course of a year.
If you spend more than a few hours outside at night, you'll see the stars and constellations seem to be circling around us, with stars moving gradually across the sky from east to west. It would be easy to imagine the motion of the celestial sphere if we lived on Earth's equator. Stars would appear to rise in the east and set in the west. If we lived on the North Pole, the stars would never rise or set. They would just circle above us. In Rockville, things are in between. We are 39 degrees above the Earth's equator, or 39 degrees latitude. The light blue plate illustrates our local horizon. For us in Rockville, some stars will never get low enough to set, and some stars, those that are close to the South Celestial Pole, will never rise for us. Stars that are near the North Celestial Pole are called circumpolar, and they never set. Stars near the South Celestial Pole are not visible. All the other stars and the Sun, the Moon, and planets rise somewhere in the east and set somewhere in the west. The image in the back shows a photo where the camera shutter has been left open for a few minutes. The lines you see are star trails. All the stars appear to rotate around a single point. That is the North Celestial Pole. If you've ever traveled and looked at the sky, you may have noticed it looks different from different locations. The sky also looks different depending on whether it's summer or winter. Why is this? Why do the constellations we see depend on latitude and time of year? First, let's talk about variation with latitude. Latitude measures your position north or south of the equator. It's 0 at the equator, 90 degrees at the North Pole, and minus 90 degrees at the South Pole. Longitude measures your position east or west of the prime meridian. The location of the prime meridian, or the zero point for longitude, is arbitrary. It's been in different countries throughout history. It's in Greenwich, England now. Let's take an imaginary visit to the North Pole. From the North Pole, the point directly over our heads on the celestial sphere marks the North Celestial Pole. There is also a star very near to the North Celestial Pole. It is our North Star, and its official name is Polaris. The North Star isn't the brightest star in the sky. It's simply a star that happens to be close to the North Celestial Pole. Let's think about what happens to the location of Polaris and the North Celestial Pole if we start walking south. If we start walking south, Polaris will get lower in the sky. Since we're walking south, Polaris is behind us, above the northern horizon. As we keep walking, it gets lower and lower. What if we walk all the way to the equator? If we walk to the equator, Polaris will end up on our horizon. If we go below the equator, we won't be able to see Polaris anymore. The latitude at the equator is 0 degrees. The altitude of Polaris and the North Celestial Pole is also 0 degrees at the equator. Let's go back to Rockville and pretend we're facing north here. Our latitude in Rockville is 39 degrees. What then is the altitude of Polaris and the North Celestial Pole? Well, it is also 39 degrees. Polaris and the North Celestial Pole will appear to be 39 degrees off the northern horizon. The altitude of the celestial pole is always equal to your latitude. The figure on the left shows a person looking northward in the northern hemisphere. If they watch the sky over a number of hours, they will see the constellations appear to rotate counterclockwise around the North Celestial Pole, or Polaris. The picture on the right is someone looking southward in the southern hemisphere. People in the southern hemisphere do not have a pole star like we do in the northern hemisphere. They do have the constellation Crux, or the Southern Cross, that's close to the south celestial pole. If you watch the sky in the southern hemisphere facing south for a number of hours, you'll see the constellations rotate clockwise around the south celestial pole. Latitude matters. The sky from somewhere north, say Niagara Falls, looks different than the sky somewhere very south, like Sydney, Australia. But this means that people at the same latitude get to see the same sky. For example, Lisbon, Portugal, and Washington, D.C. are both at a latitude of 39 degrees. So if you have a sweetheart in Lisbon, they'll get to see the same sky that you see in Washington, D.C. You may have also noticed that the sky looks different in August compared to December. The night sky changes throughout the year because of Earth's changing position in its orbit around the sun. This figure illustrates what's happening. As Earth orbits, the sun appears to move steadily eastward along the ecliptic through different constellations. Consider the sky during the day in August. If we could see the stars when the sun was out, we would see that the sun is in the constellation of Leo. At night, we're facing the opposite direction, and Aquarius is high in the sky. Here's the view from Rockville on August 21st at noon. You can see that the sun is indeed in Leo. Now, here's the same day, only it's midnight. Aquarius is opposite Leo on the celestial sphere, so it will be out all night long. Well, we covered a lot in this lecture, so take a break, get yourself a mocha, because you completely deserve it.